And this is supposed to be art? I couldn't believe it myself 10 years ago. But after I took painting classes and learned to appreciate art over the years, I can tell you, these paintings are worth looking at. I will show you how to paint like Jackson Pollock style and make an interesting drip action painting yourself. Just after this. Hi there, my name is Albert van der Zwart. Welcome to Imperfect Paintings, where it's all about improving your painting skills by looking at art, yourself and the world around you. Thanks Nadia for requesting this video, I hope you like it. Jackson Pollock is a famous American painter who lived from 1912 to 1956 and is an abstract expressionist. In 1943 he made this mural on commission. It's 2.4 by 6.1 meter, 8 by 20 foot. And it's fascinating that this very large painting doesn't have a focal point. Every part deserves your equal attention and is interesting to look at. The story goes that the lonely artist, after struggling for months, painted this fantastic artwork in one day and one night, finishing it on time just before Christmas. This one painting put his name on the map of the art world. A few random examples of what he painted before mural. A personal style can only be developed over time, making lots of paintings. Over to the drip paintings, like these, made between 1947 and 1950. What you see is complex paintings with splashes of paint in multiple colors and multiple layers. To make it easier to understand this kind of abstract art, we start simple. Pollock used black ink, I will use my normal acrylic paint. To be able to make my paint more fluid, I add some paint pouring medium. I paint 6 euro a liter at the Action store. Stir for a while and I'm ready to go. His painting style isn't about making random splashes. You can control your movement and therefore your outcome. Everything in the art world is always a reaction. No one is an orphan. Pollock isn't unique with his drip paintings. When you look around, you can find more artists who use the technique. For instance, Janet Sobel, who possibly influenced him. The second stage is adding a second color, like in this one by Pollock. I cheated a bit because I wanted to look mine like his. The three upright black parts resemble people to me. This one is called Summertime, number 9A. And you can see he uses black, blue, yellow and a little bit of red. I should have taken longer time to think about my composition to make it more interesting. You can also start with a background color. Add black and white for a finishing touch. This week when cooking, I played around with the olive oil we use, making pollocks in the pan. The This one I make with two sheets of paper. It gives me more room to maneuver and it will be wet on wet. Because I use pouring medium to make my paint more fluid, the paint also mixes a little. It creates a different outcome. I will show you in a second. When you want to keep your layers separate, you have to wait for them to dry in between. By putting his painting on the floor, you could walk around it and apply paint from all sides. The fluid paint won't drip down like it will on an easel, so you can keep all the nice splashes. And instead of using only brushes, he also used unusual materials like the sticks I use to apply the paint. These are close-ups of the spots where the paint mixed because of the medium I use. This is the whole painting. And this is only the smaller paper. Jackson Pollock also cut his paintings to the size he wanted. Probably also because this way he could cut out the most interesting composition. It's interesting to take a closer look, as always. Preferably visit a museum and look at an original painting. When you take a closer look at this one, called Cathedral, you can see he painted in layers. When you see how it is built up, you can make your own Pollock-style painting. Start with looking for the background color and try to analyze in what order the paint has been layered. I came up with ochre, grey and white for the background. For the first layers, you often use the palette knife, probably a bigger one. This cathedral painting is 181 cm by 89 cm, 74 by 35 inch. To create a more interesting background, only paint parts of the paper or canvas with your colors. Over to the stains, drips and splashes. I start with black. This first part is in real time. I will speed things up a bit. To make it more realistic, I move my paper a bit to the left to be able to drip beyond the edges of my paper and clean up the mess afterwards. Some extra spots between these larger drips. And when dry, I take white paint. And oops, on the carpet too. So I first have to clean it. When painting, do pay attention how you apply the paint. Here you can see the result of sweeping my hand faster or slower. It results in different stains. Make sure you vary enough. And even when you make the same move, apply it from another side of the painting, like here, keeps it from getting dull. The next colors are dark grey, burnt sienna, white, black and some dark grey to finish. Jackson Pollock used different sorts of paint. Aluminium paint, radiator paint, oil paint and others. He also put all sorts of other materials in it. You can find keys, cigarette butts, nails or buttons. Let's look for a second at the result. I like it and I enjoyed making it. Question of the day. Are you planning to make a Jackson Pollock yourself? Let me know in the comments down below. Now let's look at the cathedral one by Pollock and mine together. What you see is that they don't look alike. I wasn't even trying to copy him, I was more painting in his style. But his one is larger, so I take an equal part of his one the size of mine. Now the stains look more equal in size, but still very different. It has probably to do with how fluid the paint is, and I also try to keep my studio a bit clean. The information that I'm missing is how he actually worked. I know there's a film made by Hans Namuth, link up here. This is a screenshot of Pollock painting on glass for him. To make mine, or yours when you try this yourself, look more alike, you have to experiment how to create these stains. But still, when I look around in my work, I see multiple interesting layers of paint. What I learned from painting Jackson Pollock style is that my cat couldn't do this. I have trouble recreating one, although I'm happy with mine. It was very interesting to investigate Pollock's artwork. A totally different choice in painting is keeping it simple and intriguing at the same time. I can introduce you to a female American painter who plays with happy colors in her paintings and ceramics, and she even makes her own furniture. Click on the link and I will see you over there in the next video.